Ziplines in Apex Legends can be used to quickly reposition over long and short distances, horizontally and vertically. But there's so much more to them than just this basic use case. In this video, I'll explain everything from the fundamentals of the zipline up to all the advanced shenanigans you can do with it. Step number one, find the zipline. You can train a lot of these techniques in the training mode where you don't have to worry about the live game around you. I will try to demonstrate as much as possible in the actual map. Let's here also talk about the only creator that can gift us with more ziplines. While aiming Pathfinder zipline, you can ADS to zoom in a bit. If you don't have a magnifying scope on a weapon, this can help in spotting enemies. If you point the zipline at a target and then simply walk backwards, while letting completely go of your view input, you can create comically long ziplines. Weirdly enough, this hasn't been patched yet, but on the other hand, it only works well in very certain locations. And dropping a zipline for you and your team quickly is often much more important than getting more range out of it by walking backwards first. Be also aware that using a zipline cancels all momentum you had previously. You cannot bunny hop off them to keep your pre-existing speed. So especially when slingshotting around them with Pathy, it's not always a good idea to use them, even if it's tempting. But that does not mean that he should avoid them. His ability to grapple the zipline can make for some awesome use cases. While I have a redeploy balloon on screen, you can jump off, hold backwards, look up, and the prompt to interact will show up after a bit. Another funny but often useless trick is to put multiple ziplines next to each other and spam jump between them while holding interact. Once you have found or created a zipline, it's time for step number two, using the zipline. Press interact to ride it from one side to the other. Little side note, on World's Edge all ziplines besides the redeploy balloons have a predetermined direction at which you will leave the zipline. To get influence over that, you need to use step number three, disconnecting. You can disconnect from a zipline by crouching. Use this in conjunction with air strafing to drop on a specific target, or dropping off the zipline into cover really quickly. Step number four, disconnecting with a jump. For this, I really want to emphasize the importance of air strafing while disconnecting off a zipline. Just looking in the direction you want to end up with will not get you far. So especially while using jump disconnect during combat, air strafing will be your best friend. Jumping off a zipline also gives you a noticeable boost compared to your normal jump. We are going to exploit this to come up with all sorts of maneuvers. For example, if you jump off a horizontal zipline, you jump high enough to be able to reconnect to it. You can use this to turn around on a zipline, and doing this in quick succession lets you sort of bunny hop on it. This is great for avoiding enemy fire, but be aware that bee hopping on a zipline can trash your speed, especially uphill, so use it mindfully. I trained myself to hold interact throughout an entire zipline ride, so if I'm getting shot at, I'm immediately ready for evasive maneuvers. Holding interact is also helpful in switching to a crossing zipline. With this, I want to transition into a very important point. Try not to think about ziplines as rails that have a fixed point A and B between which you have to travel. The entire 3D space around them is open to you if you interact with them in the correct way. To really drive this point home, I will now talk about zipline super jumping. Run up to a vertical zipline while holding interact and jump as soon as you connect to it. Try it a bunch of times to get the delay between interact and jump shorter and shorter. Then try to not hold interact, but pressing jump and interact together at the same time as you're crossing the zipline. Yes, it helps to start this practice by holding interact to find the point where you cross the zipline. But I found all advanced super jump maneuvers to be much easier to perform precise by just pressing interact for every jump. Here I have to mention that this is much easier to do if you assign your scroll wheel as a second jump input. If you want to use space or are on controller, you want to press interact a tiny bit before jump, because it doesn't seem to register the jump if you do it at the exact same time. Scroll wheel jumping also seems to be the only way to get a boosted super jump, where you get much more height and range. I claimed in my movement guide that inputting a crouch with the super jump also enables a boosted one. But I tested this some more since then and I cannot get a boosted super jump to work with spacebar, with or without a crouch input. But doing it well timed with a scroll wheel jump, I get a boosted one every time. So for now I'm claiming that a boosted super jump is not possible on controller, but I'm very open to being corrected here. While getting familiar with the super jump, you might start to notice that you cannot only do this maneuver in one straight line, but also change direction with it. You can either jump onto the zipline, which allows you to turn your view before hitting it, or you can turn while being connected to the zipline. But this of course only works if there is a gap between the connect and the jump. So I genuinely recommend you play around with all of this for a while, until you feel really comfortable with the basic super jump, before getting totally funky with zipline dancing. I didn't even have a name for this back when I showed it in my movement guide edition 2 months ago. Then I called it the dizzy move for a while after his clip of using it spread awareness of it, before going over to calling it zipline climbing while working on this video, to now zipline dancing after having seen Ace use it and show it off in his new movement guide. Okay, what the hell is happening here? Let's slow it down. You super jump off the zipline into the direction you are looking as you're super jumping, and then turn your view quick enough to re-engage with it before getting thrown out of the interactable zone. If you then do this on repeat, you are zipline dancing. It helps to look up, but with the correct timing, you can also do it while looking straight. Doing this on ziplines indoors is also easier, since the walls are there to sort of bounce you back to the zipline. But you will need to find a very specific rhythm to do it more than just 2 to 3 times. And it requires a lot of practice, even with scroll wheel jumping and the flick speed of the mouse. Also, do not only focus on just this dry practice zipline dancing. It's not just this one fancy looking technique with 5 or 6 chained super jumps. Zipline dancing is more of an umbrella term to get you to think freely about using ziplines and combining the things you learned. So there is a lot to practice. But in the end, the invested effort will pay off and you will truly understand what I mean when I say the entire 3D space around ziplines is open to you. I hope this was another enlightening movement guide for you. Thanks so much for watching till the end. I'll see you in the next video.